are at the Proctors Theater in Schenectady, New York. Tonight is Poetry in Motion, and it's a show consisting of just poets doing their thing, performing on stage. So it's me, and it's like 16 or 17 other poets. I really couldn't decide what poem to do, but I'm going to do my hair poem. And if I'm called back up on stage, then I'll do the poem that I did in the Bronx.
Hey, D!
Hi! That was Kevin Peterson, another poet, okay. Calling me out. My earrings, these are hand-painted earrings. And I'll show one of them. This is like a woman, her hair blowing in the wind, and the scarf in her hand. This is a wood piece, and I used acrylic paint to paint them, and then I drilled a hole and put the, forgot what this part is called, the hook or whatever that goes into your ear to make it an earring. But I like big earrings. I wanted to wear big earrings tonight. I don't always wear big earrings, I don't think, but this is more for advertisement. So people can ask me, hey, I like your earrings, where'd you get those? And I can tell them I made these so I can sell some earrings. So that's really why I'm wearing them. Is it real? And what do you use? Now that I've transitioned from straight hair to my natural self, it's like people have hypertension. Share all sorts of comments and questions like, how long does that take you? As if they didn't sit for hours getting the Senegalese twist or their wash and set, as if they didn't take the time to scratch the dandruff out for so long and fall asleep on someone's knee. And then there's my pet peeve. Can I touch it? As if I'm someone's exotic pet. Go find a poodle. Or comments like, you know Easter Sunday is coming up, what are you going to do with that? This one is usually accompanied by a look of concern. Oh, why didn't you comb your hair today? Oh, it's combed, but you can't run the comb through. Oh, you can. But how do you get this off? Wait, it's soft. All of these are usually accompanied by a look of confusion. And the list goes on. Like, are you ever going to straighten that? I mean, you're going to straighten that for your wedding, right? What about graduation? You don't think you look like an old lady? Well, speechless with raised eyebrows. Are you Jamaican? Again, speechless. There are two straight twists, not locks, and then not all Jamaicans have locks. So why don't you just get locks? I see this as a pointless conversation. Doesn't matter if my hair is out or a two-strand twist, braided on the side, faux hawk in the middle, or wash and go. If it's not straight, some people just don't understand. Makes me want to have discussion on the effects of colonialism on the mind, the brainwashing of the media, the overwhelming abundance of images of black women with long, flowing hair. When we really know the truth, when we know our hair blows in the wind only on the day we leave the salon, and then it's all hope. Makes me want to have arguments like, if a man only wants me because I have straight hair, maybe he shouldn't have me at all. And if a job won't hire me, maybe I need to hire myself. And if you can't handle looking at my hair on Easter Sunday, maybe you should question why it is you go to church. I will not be straightening my hair, not for my wedding or graduation. Besides the fact that this thing on my head, referred to as that, it's just the way it grows.